Welcome back to the show. It is going to be an awesome episode today. We are talking about how you actually use your mission, vision, and values. Now, we've been going through this series, diving into my book, TeamWork, and doing a book club. So through this book club, so far, if you haven't listened to the other episodes, this episode might be a little challenging because I'm expecting that you already have a mission, vision, and values to use, to display, to really live out throughout your culture. And if you don't have mission, vision, values, I would highly recommend going back through, restarting the book club, getting clear on those things, because how to use it is kind of challenging if you don't actually have them. You know what I mean? So with that, chapter 5 is the shortest chapter of my book, Teamwork. It's quite literally like one page. Maybe it's even half of a page. I don't know that it's a full page. Because I give examples inside the book as to where to use your mission, vision, values. So the first example that I give is in your job descriptions. So every time you craft a new job description, you should have what I like to call a company overview. This is a place where you put the most important things about your business right at the front. And the most important things would be why you do what you do, where your business is going, and what your core values are, how you describe your culture. This sets up the interviewer to know what these things are in your business. So when you have them, you have to really use them in the job description, because fast forward to the acceptance process and to them onboarding, if you didn't put them in the job description and you never told them in the interview process, how are you expecting people to just magically know what your mission, vision, values are? You should ideally align on these things prior to somebody joining your organization so that they're already starting in entire alignment with your business. Alignment is one of our core values, so we're bringing that to you with being able to create that inside your organization. So first up is job descriptions and job posts. The second piece is the interview process. So later in Teamwork, we dive into exactly what our interview process is that has allowed us to hire 188 employees over the last 36 months. This process is tried and true, and I'll give you a little sneak peek. One of the questions ties in our mission and vision statement, and then one of the steps in the process is entirely focused around the core values. So we're not just trying to create words and pretty pictures and a once in a quarter conversation around our mission, vision, values. We're actually using them appropriately. We are using our mission, our vision, and our values in order to hire people, in order to assess performance, ideally to give people promotions when they're able to exemplify these core values. And if in the case that somebody isn't living up to these core values, they're also exiting because of them. They're no longer working with you. You're firing them because they do not believe in or align with your mission, vision, and values. So the second piece that you use them in is the interview process. Now, the third piece is performance review conversations. Now, it is October, what is it, the 6th today? Our performance review process is about to kick off here in just a couple of weeks. Now, performance can be reviewed through a variety of different lenses. You could just look at the work that somebody has done. You could just look at how they align with your culture. In an ideal scene, you're using both of those lenses to give somebody feedback. I like to think of our performance review process as the place where somebody can really understand what they need to develop in order to get to where they want to go. It's not some game for the company to play to have hard conversations that don't go anywhere or just useless time spent talking about how great everything is. It really is the ultimate coaching opportunity inside your business. So our mission, our vision, and our core values should be demonstrated throughout the performance review process. You should be using your core values throughout your performance review process. If you're not using your core values and you're never really reassessing that somebody has come in and they've continued to live by these core values through the performance review, what is the point of having them? Like, think about that. Why have them? Just to feel good? Just to have words that you like? No, they should be usable for this performance review process. And later in TeamWork, I just dive into the full performance review process and give you all of the templates that you need for emails to send out and the structure and the forms. But just think with, how do you assess performance based off of your core values? And this also helps you recognize, is this the right core value? If you use a core value like fun, think about sitting down at the end of a year and doing a performance review. How am I going to give somebody more pay or more responsibility based off of their ability to live up to the core value fun? How am I going to do that? I don't understand how somebody would do that, which is why I don't recommend a core value of fun. Now, not to say that we don't have fun around here. We have a lot of fun. We have culture events, and there's this dad joke thing that happens in our chat every morning. And I really do believe that our team members think of Cardinal Ventures as a fun place to work, unless they're not hitting their metrics, in which they probably don't think it's a very fun place to work. But there is still those elements inside your business. It's not to say that they don't exist, but when you use your core values in your performance review process, you will really be able to assess, hey, is this working for us? Are these the right core values for us? I remember back in 2015, I rolled out core values in an organization I was working in, and I revamped our core values after the performance review process because I realized that there were a handful of things that I didn't have criteria to give feedback with because I had never created the criteria correctly to begin with. There were a couple of core values that were like duplicates. And so there was this thing that I was like looking for to be able to coach somebody off of, but because I wasn't like, that wasn't already listed in the core value set, I had to figure out this other way to give that feedback, which is where new core values came from and a re-look at our existing core values took place. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I would much rather have a business owner just commit to a mission, vision, core values, iterate off of it, and then roll out a new version in 6 months when they realize, oh wait, this didn't quite fit and this didn't work out the way that we wanted it to. Instead of spending months and months never committing, having the team not be clear, and then you never end up rolling it out because it never really is perfect. So commit to it, use it in the performance review process. The performance review process really is the game changer and the greatest way to see, hey, is this criteria really working inside of my business? Next up, the best way to start an all-team meeting is reminding people why they're there. I'm just gonna be honest with you. I wake up some mornings and can just start going through the motions. I can just start executing on things that I know have to be done without really taking a step back to remember why I'm doing it. And in the days where I'm stressed out, in the days where I'm struggling, in the days where I feel like quitting or giving up, those are always the days that I know I haven't started off from a place of why are we doing this? And when you can align a team around a shared vision and a shared direction and shared values, you're gonna have a much easier time moving through all of the work. A few days ago, I had a team member who I know was having a challenging day, and they reached out to me saying, you know, thank you for guidance, thank you for your support. And my response back was, one day we're going to laugh about this, but right now when we're in the trenches, it's just part of doing the work. And their response back to me was, well, I would rather be doing this and be in the trenches with this team than anywhere else. And I like to think of it like that. Like, just because you have a great mission and a great vision and great core values doesn't mean that hard work isn't going to take place in your environment. There is a lot of hard work that is going to take place, but at least you're starting off from this place of, why are we doing this? Where are we going? How does this tie into my goals? And when you start off an all-team meeting with your mission, your vision, values, it just grounds the whole thing. It centers it. It's not for ego. It's not for Natalie to look really smart or the department heads to just flaunt all of the great things. It's really about our customers. Hey, we're here to help a million business owners achieve their personal, professional, and financial goals through the growth of their businesses. Oh yeah, when we're on that mission, Natalie's ego doesn't mean anything because I'm here to help and serve somebody else. I'm here to help somebody attain their goals. That is the first slide out of every single quarterly team meeting that I use to kick it off, because I want to make sure that we're all clear on exactly what's happening inside our organization. Next up, core values. I've seen some cool things with email signatures. People actually put their mission, they put their why in their email signatures. I think that's a really great way to remind not only your team members, but also your clients of why you exist. And when your clients read that in your email, if your team members aren't living up to those things, your client's actually more likely to reach out and say, hey, I know you guys believe in this, but this is the experience that I had. And as a business owner, you are looking for that. It makes me frustrated at myself when I have a business experience and interact with a small business owner and there's something that goes wrong, nobody answers the phone, there's a sloppy process, it's a bad experience, and I don't say anything. Because if I don't say anything, I'm not taking responsibility to help that business owner. And so it's one of my tenets, it's one of my policies that anytime I experience something that's wrong or that I would want somebody to tell me if it was my business, I make it my mission to make sure that that feedback was given. And it's not for the purpose of me just being an asshole to every small business that I come in contact with. It's really because I know that that's what I would want to have in our environment. I would want one of our clients to tell me and give me that feedback. And so putting it in your email signature first makes the statement that this is what you're all about, but then also it's that reminder, it's that gentle thing that's opening the doors for feedback so that your product, your service, your offering can get better and your clients know what you're committed to. All right, next up, this is a long list. We got a very long list going on here because there are a variety of ways that you can and you should be using your core values outside of the traditional ways, which I'll get to in just a second. But your website, if you do not have a page that says www.insertcompanyname.com/careers that has your mission, your vision, and your core values, that is an immediate action item. Run, don't walk, go do that now. This is where you should be driving flow. You should be driving candidates. You should be talking about, hey, if you want to apply for a job at Cardone Ventures, go to cardoneventures.com/careers. I probably promote that link once a day because I know that the biggest challenge our business has is sharing with people that we're hiring and getting great talent in the door to be able to help solve large problems on behalf of our organization. If you don't have one of these pages or it's difficult to get to and it doesn't have your mission, vision, values, what are you doing? Do it now. That's what you're doing. You're doing it right now. You're pausing this podcast and you're doing it now. Okay, now that we're back, another like checklist item, it's fairly straightforward, but sometimes people don't think with your handbook. Your handbook should have mission, vision, values in it. And in order to make your handbook process extra juicy in your environment, I am a big proponent of a handbook quiz. So if you're an employee at Cardone Ventures, there's a quiz at the end of our onboarding that goes over different onboarding items, but also a specific handbook quiz and specific handbook items. So I get two takes at ensuring that everybody inside our organization knows what our mission, our vision, and our values are. I sleep very well at night because of this, and my sleep is very important to me. I like sleep. I'm an 8-hour a night kind of girl. It makes me very happy to sleep well. I'm not going to be sleeping very well if nobody knows what our mission, vision, values are. And so the handbook, once it's in there, that would be the first three quiz questions that I would have in the handbook quiz. Hey, what is Cardone Ventures' mission statement? What is Cardone Ventures' vision statement? What is Cardone Ventures' core values? So there's this checkpoint in the employee integration process. All right, this is where it gets a little traditional. Your mission, vision, and core values should be in your office. Now, this is not the only place it should be. Most people start here. They post it on a wall, they make some cool plaque, and they think, yep, I'm good to go. I put it on my walls. Everybody knows the mission, vision, values. Wrong. Most organizations do this. It's actually what causes a lot of people to distrust mission, vision, values. Now, I still believe that you should do this and it's still important to do, but it's not the only thing you do. I would say it's like 1/20th of the equation for truly implementing strategically mission, vision, and values. So inside our organization, when you walk into our headquarters in Scottsdale, Arizona, you see our core values. They're listed. They're literally right outside my office. I can see them from here. And it lists the name of the core value and then also what our definitions are so that any visitors understand this, but it's also a reminder to our team, hey, this is what we're about here. We're disciplined, we're accountable, we're transparent, we're aligned, we're results oriented. All of those visual reminders helps to create a culture. And as I know very well, it's difficult for me sometimes to feel like being disciplined. I know every day I don't wake up just inspired and wanting to be highly accountable. It's not like human beings are just like that. And so the more visual cues you can have to create your culture, the better. And it's important to not just let it be the visual cues though. Like that's the side piece. It's great to have, really important for those other pieces to be in place to actually live into that, to actually create a real culture, not just have it on the walls. But I am curious, do you currently have a display of your mission, vision, and values? I would love to see any photos that you have. I know organizations all do this differently, and there's some really cool creative ways that you can display your core values. I was at a workout class the other day, and I saw the core values on these little wood things that were hung on the wall in this really interesting pattern. And I felt great as a customer. I felt like it was a really cool customer experience to see what the core values were and their definitions of those core values through these like wooden, I don't know, they're almost like a puzzle piece. So if you do have core values or your mission statement or your vision on a wall, you should tag me in it. I would love to see that. And if you have questions about mission, vision, and core values, one of the things we're gonna start incorporating into the show is more feedback and more interactions. And so any questions that you have, we're going to start having a special spot on the show for me to go through those questions. So do you want me to review your mission? Do you feel good about it, but you might want some tweaks to it? Send me your mission through Instagram DMs. That's the best place to get a hold of me. And on next week's episode, when we dive into chapter 6, I'm going to go through and review those questions and any of the feedback that you guys are having through rolling out what you've created for your mission, vision, values. Until then, be great. Can't wait to see you, and I'll see you next episode.